In other words, should I wait? If we were to listen to all the entertainment media messages, I think the answer to should I wait is, no, don't wait, go for it, it feels good now. But I want to sit there and I want to look at the answer. I want to look at it a couple different ways. One of the ways I want to look at it is I want to look at this answer biblically. Let's look at the biblical answer to this. And that means starting in the very beginning. Because see, sadly, I think that a lot of people, when they hear us talk about sex, they immediately think, oh, sex, in the church context, oh, that's that naughty thing. Honestly, it's like for some reason or another, we have in this country deemed that sex was this naughty thing, and so we don't seem to talk about it much in church, which is sad because, believe it or not, in this Bible, the Bible talks about it really clear. If you even were reading the Bible with your parents sometimes, you'd get to certain passages and maybe you'd blush or something because you're like, wow, this is really talked about. It's talking totally clear. For example, in the very beginning, think of the beginning story in the Bible. If you were to open up to Genesis right now, and if you got Bibles, you can. The opening story is God creates the earth and there's this naked guy named Adam walking around the garden. And God looks down and he says this. He goes, hey, it's not good for man to be alone. So what's he do? Poof! Naked woman. Right there! Right there in the Bible! And then when he does this, Adam is like, this is good! Yeah! Alright? Naked guy, garden, naked woman appears. It gets better. When this happens in Genesis chapter 1, verse 28, God says this. He says, be fruitful and multiply. In other words, God's saying, you can do it. That's what he's saying right there. Now, a lot of us might look at this and think, well, that's kind of embarrassing. But honestly, God isn't just saying something like, oh, make babies. Because God gave something to man that he doesn't give to animals. I mean, it is so much more than just making babies. He gives all this pleasure where a lot of animals, they just go into heat and it's just during the moment of heat. But with humans, he gives us this awesome pleasure and it bonds us. It's amazing. And God created this and it was good and he wanted us to do it. Now, the thing is, lots of times, let's be honest. How many times have you heard somebody preaching on Sunday morning about that? You don't hear that a lot. But it's one of those things. This is the way God created it. He intended it. Now, if you got your Bibles, I encourage you to even go a little further to the right here into the book of Proverbs. Because in the book of Proverbs, he's going to talk about sex. The author here is going to talk about sex, and he's going to talk specifically to a young man. And he's going to say something that I think might surprise some of you here. Because he's going to talk about how good sex is. Proverbs chapter 5, here's what he says, and I'll put it up on the screen as I read. Because he says this, he says, in Proverbs chapter 5, verse 18 through 20, he says this. He says, let your wife be a fountain of blessing for you. Rejoice in the wife of your youth. He says, she's a loving deer, a graceful doe. He's getting all poetic on this, right? He says, let her breasts satisfy you always. Some of you are like, oh, whoa, man, that's pretty intense, all right? He says, may you always be captivated by her love. But don't stop there. Keep reading because this is intense stuff. He says, why be captivated, my son, by an immoral woman or fondle the breasts of a promiscuous woman? Promiscuous means someone who sleeps with all kinds of different men. So here's a passage where he starts off and he says, hey, young men, or he might even be talking to older men as they're getting older and maybe they're kind of looking around at other women and they're thinking of, hey, do I want to sleep with some other women too? And he goes, hey, guys, remember this wife you married, this young woman. He goes, enjoy her always. And he's not even embarrassed to say, hey, enjoy her. Let her breast satisfy you at all times. I mean, if he was talking today and it was a guy talking to other guys, he might even say, hey, enjoy your wife's boobs, man. I mean, this is cool. This is just what he's saying. He's talking in their language at that time. It wasn't something dirty. It wasn't something naughty. He's saying, enjoy your wife's breasts. He says, I hope they bring you all kinds of satisfaction. Why? That's the way God created it. Now, I know some of you guys are sitting there going, that's a cool verse. I'm going to write that down. My youth pastor always told me to memorize scripture. I'm going to memorize that verse right there. May her breast satisfy me. Oh, it's okay. Good job, guys. That's a good one. Keep that. But if you do memorize that verse, don't forget the verses to follow. Because the verses to follow are important. Sadly, sometimes when you guys are browsing the internet, sometimes when you guys are looking at stuff on your phone, sometimes you come across pictures. And sometimes you find these pictures, and if it hasn't happened yet, it's going to happen now, or sometime you're going to stumble upon these pictures, and you might see some other naked women. And here, right here, in the truth of the Bible is saying, hey, God's got this young man, God's got a special woman for you, and he wants you to enjoy your breasts. But if you're enjoying a bunch of other women's breasts, it's going to take away from that special gift you have. So here's one of those awesome passages where he tells us that sex is this awesome gift for us to enjoy with the person that we're going to spend the rest of our life with.